What's up, y'all, biscuit heads? Duke to the motherfudging bump here. About to lay it out for you. This is a freestyle rap that I just made up. I like to call it Mario 3 is where it be. Can I get a beat? No beat? Oh, darn, I guess I can't rap. Oh, what a shame. I know you're all looking forward to it so much. Since I am such an excellent rapper. And the award for best rapper ever goes to... Oh, not me. What the... How do I get in there? It is a mystery. Maybe like this. Can I jump? No. Crud. And there's a flower there. Great. 10,000 flowers when all you need is a leaf. I think that might be ironic, but I'm not sure. I know it's not like rain on your wedding day. There's a pretty good secret around here somewhere. You have to be patient to get to it, but... what was I going to say? I don't know, something about patience. And if we go over here, above this thing, I guess it's not really a secret so much as it's an out-of-the-way area. Oops. No, that's okay. And it's another one of these mysterious white block areas. Yeah, when the giant question mark gives you a power-up, it doesn't matter if you're big or small. You get it anyway. I don't know why it bothers giving you a frog suit here. I mean, it's only going to be useful for another, 60 seconds maybe. Then we're going to beat the level and we're going to go off to the boss and... We're going to look ridiculous fighting a boss in a freaking frog suit. Absolutely ridiculous. Oh, and now we'll be able to get a star. I'll try anyway. If I hit it just right. Alright. And we're up to 55 extra lives. Yeah. I'm pretty awesome. What can I say? Oh, I hate having a frog suit above water.
Help! Help, it's terrible! The king was turned into a weird-looking turtle thing. It doesn't look like any of the other turtles in this game, though.
I don't know what that's supposed to be. Maybe that's their realistic portrayal of a turtle, and the Koopas are supposed to be genetically modified turtles. I don't know. I don't pretend to understand. I should just lose the frog suit now. It's not going to do anything but annoy me. There we go. Aww. Why you gotta be like that? I kinda wanna challenge someone to LP this game using only the frog suit through the entire game, not losing it. Man, that would be annoying as hell. Of course, you wouldn't be able to get the frog suit until, World War II. It doesn't show up before then. So you'd have at least a couple worlds of sanity. Sometimes there's stuff to the right of this pipe, so you want to check and see. Oh, it's windy. I don't like windy. Oh, you're nowhere near as good as the hamburgers that bear your name. After that ship. Oh, you cute little pixies are as sweet as the candy that bears your name. Pixie sticks. Man, I envy any kid who convinces his mom to buy him pixie sticks. It's like, okay, Junior, what kind of candy do you want? I want sugar in a paper tube, Mommy. I don't know, pure sugar. That's not a very good candy. But Mommy, I want it. No, don't go that way, go this way. I mean, I had pixie sticks, but, you know, not until I was much older. Old enough to know the consequences of my actions. Yeah, I got hooked on the stuff. Lost my home, my job, everything. Had to sell my body on the streets just for one quick fix. Kids, don't play with too many knives. You know, one or two is okay. Alright, fine, let's get big. I hate Wendy. Freaking Wendy Okupa. So I was surfing around the internet randomly, and I happened upon this thing on the PETA website, People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals. And it was this little copyright-infringing flash game called the Super Chick Sisters. And you play as these two, you know, chicks, baby chickens, and one of them's name is Nugget, and the other one's name is Chickadee or something, I don't know. Anyway, the plot is, you're going after Colonel Sanders for his inhumane treatment of chickens, which, I don't know, if you're going to eat them, does it really matter how humane you are? I mean, come on. They're just going to end up being eaten anyway. So yeah, it was a pretty big load of, you know, vegetarian propaganda. But damn it, the game was just so cute. I mean, you were these adorable little baby chicks. Eat it, bitch! And, you know, everything was just so adorable. The Colonel Sanders, he was like this evil-looking caricature of, you know, the Southern gentleman. Oh, thank heavens. Hey, that dude looks suspiciously like Mario. He's a little darker, but I don't know. I think there may be a family resemblance there. Hey, music box. Alright, this is one of my favorite worlds, I think. Let me check and make sure. Oops, wrong one. What was that chime? It sounded like... Oh, okay, it's an inspade. Aw, man, I have to go through the inspade to get... Aw, that's bogus, man. Utter bogosity. Yeah, just hurry up and let me lose. But anyway, yeah, don't play Super Chick Sisters because, I mean, you know, they're trying to brainwash us. So yeah, tune in next time for the next world of Super Mario Bros. 3, in which we sit on the shoulders of giants. See you later.